My name is Jonas Feldheim. I'm a member of the Tumor Biology Research Group of the Neurosurgical Department of the University of Würzburg. And in the next few minutes, I would like to give you a short overview of our paper. The main topic of our research is glioblastoma multiforme, the most common primary brain tumor that even with current standard therapy shows a rather unfavorable prognosis. Therefore, new therapeutical options, especially systemically applied targeted therapy, would be highly desirable. The transcription factor TF5 has been reported to be overexpressed in GBM and has been proposed as such a potential therapeutic target. It is involved in the differentiation of neuroprogenitors, promotes cell survival and the maintenance of a stem cell-like state, whereas loss of TF5 expression leads to differentiation of cells. Suppression of TF5 led to selective death of tumor cells, but not of normal astrocytes. Clinical data on TF5 in astrocytic tumors is scarce, and therefore the question arose whether TF5 is specifically overexpressed in glioblastomas or even in certain subgroups of glioblastomas, or whether it is generally overexpressed in astrocytic tumors and therefore may have potential as a therapeutic target independently of the biological behavior. We collected 79 GBM, 40 astrocytoma grade 2 and 10 more normal brain specimens. We performed TF5 immunohistochemistry, quantitative real-time PCR and retrospectively collected data on the clinical course of the patients and known prognostic factors. We found the TF5 messenger RNA to be significantly overexpressed in low-grade astrocytoma and glioblastoma when compared to normal brain, whereas the tumors showed a similar expression independently of their grade of malignancy or biological behavior. The messenger RNA expression data were confirmed on protein level by immunohistochemistry. Kaplan-Ndash analysis, comparing the clinical course of patients with high TF5 and low TF5 messenger RNA expression, revealed a significantly impaired short-term survival of the high expression group, whereas there was no difference between the long-term survivors. We suggest this effect to be at least partly explained by the high expression group showing early tumor relapse or progression, which can be seen in the second Kaplan-Meier plot. To sum up, we could show that TF5 overexpression was independent of WHO grade and of varying biological behavior in GBM. We conclude that TF5 might indeed serve as a ubiquitous therapeutic target in astrocytic tumors, and clinical trials are definitely advisable to further evaluate the therapeutic potential of TF5.